Today I'm going to show you how I painted some apple palm leaves with a little warbler peeking out from them. These leaves are going to have some bright highlights and shadows. These things are what will give them texture. I'm letting the part of the leaf that's not being filled in with this dark gray act as a sort of negative space to create this line pattern. I'm blocking where my white goes now. Some of this is going to be very important later on. I've mixed two different shades of green for my leaf. I'm doing this to tone down the green without completely flattening it, which is what adding red would have done. I also want them to be super reflective, so I'm trying really hard not to cover up this white that I painted. Let me tell you, painting bright white highlights isn't as easy as you might think. In my photo, this branch looked white at first glance, but it's actually a light brownish color. There's even some purple in this leaf. These leaves need to be a lot more vibrant, so I'm applying another layer of that same green mixture I described earlier over them. I seem to see a light pinkish brown in the warbler. Putting in these yellow leaves and emphasizing the texture of these big green leaves with some yellow paint and a mop brush. I want the veins of these leaves to be extremely thin, so I'm just using the very tip of my liner brush and letting it barely touch the canvas. I even made them a little too thick, so I'm thinning them down with a wet brush. I went over it with more green to blend the veins into the body of the leaf, but I think I blended it too much. Because I want this yellow to have some opacity, I decided to use the cadmium yellow in the soft body line from Liquitex. That's more opaque than either the Amsterdam or the Liquitex Basics yellows that I've been using. There. I've just mixed purple and yellow for these guys. Another layer on this guy. And don't do what I did. Don't paint a bunch of details before you're happy with your base shade. I create a lot of unnecessary work for myself here. I'm using the cadmium yellow for these highlights because they weren't showing up enough with the transparent yellow that I was using. Putting back in the veins that I lost. There are some pink spots on the warbler. There's some patches on the leaf. Remember I said getting bright white highlights wasn't as easy as you might think? Well, don't keep going back over your strokes, Sarah, is what I need to tell myself. You're taking paint off. Just paint one stroke and move on. But anyway, now we're getting somewhere with this. I'm getting those blindingly bright highlights that I wanted. There's some on this leaf too. Anyway, adding even more yellow. I want these marks to be obvious, but fuzzy, if that makes any sense. I'm really struggling to come up with the words for what I'm trying to say here, but I hope you get it. I'm adding even more texture with the liner brush, including crinkly details between the veins. Adding this texture and getting it right is a key to making the leaf look realistic. So one of the last things I'm doing is filling in these, I don't even know what you call them, they might even be bruises actually, but these little brown spots on the leaves. I know I didn't go into a lot of detail about painting feathers in this video, but here's one that'll help you with that. And remember to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity. Thanks for watching.